Modern technology is complex. It takes hundreds of thousands of people to develop and build the components in a state-of-the-art smartphone. Electronics are getting so sophisticated that it is not surprising many people are confused about what modern phones are actually capable of. Today, I want to focus on mobile phone location tracking. How phones can be tracked in practice, what is theoretically possible, but also common misconceptions. When we think about who might want to track a phone, usually three types of entities come to mind: governments and law enforcement, companies, and individuals. All of them have different resources, which determines the type of location tracking they are capable of. The types of tracking highlighted in this video are by no means exhaustive. Also, many of the technologies aren't freely available, which means the academic literature on them might be based on reverse engineering. One of the oldest phone tracking methods already worked in the pre-smartphone era. Triangulation works with angles and measures the signal strength of different cell towers to a phone. If at least two towers are within reach at the same time, the rough location of the phone can be calculated. The more towers are within reach, the more precise the result. And if the target is a modern smartphone, trackers can use a similar, much more precise process called trilateration. This method works by calculating the distances from different cell towers using the time of arrival of the different signals. Conveniently, newer phones might even include their exact GPS coordinates in a response to the cell tower, which makes any calculations unnecessary. Usually, only telecommunication companies have access to the cell tower data, and there is no way to hide from this kind of tracking as long as a phone with a registered SIM card is powered on. Edward Snowden explained it during a 2021 discussion with the Electronic Frontier Foundation. Unfortunately, the audio quality wasn't great.
How does the network know where you're at when you got location services turned off, right? You know, when you have Wi-Fi turned off, when you have Bluetooth turned off, when you have GPS turned off, but you're still connected to the network, right? Well, you're registering to the nearest cell phone tower to you, saying, here I am, here I am. Your phone is constant screaming out at you, here I am, here I am. Is there a cell phone tower that hears me? And the cell phone tower goes, I hear you. You create a handshake, and then whoever owns that cell phone tower enters you into a register. It can be a home register if that's where you're frequently in the network. It can be a visitor register if you're like off. But then they share this upstream. The phone globally knows where all phones are at all times. That's how they can signal to each other wherever you are, right? And location services doesn't turn that off.
Yep.
Because it can't turn that off.
Some network providers even openly use this data for more than providing cell service. For example, for serving location-based ads. To illustrate how revealing this geolocation data can be, German politician Malte Spitz requested 6 months of his own phone data in 2009. An online tool displays the timeline of his life during this period. You can clearly see how cell towers tracked his movements. No wonder that law enforcement agencies often request access to this data to aid with investigations. A comprehensive FBI cellular analysis guide from 2019 that was unclassified in 2021 demonstrates how important for policing geolocation data is nowadays. Well-equipped police forces may use so-called cell site simulators for large events like rallies. These mobile cell towers can be used to record the presence of nearby cell phones to track attendance, but are often also capable of more complex attacks like communication interception. On a smaller scale, individuals are able to track objects or people by attaching products like Apple's AirTags to the target. AirTags, or similarly their competitor Tile, work by communicating with nearby Bluetooth devices. An AirTag in a person's coat pocket or stuck to a car gets updated every time a Bluetooth-enabled Apple device is in close proximity. For example, in January 2022, software developer Lilith Wittmann successfully located the offices of a secret German federal agency by simply mailing them an AirTag. These tracking devices usually have anti-stalking features to avoid tracking people without consent, but unfortunately, they can often be disabled and generally require actions on the target's side. To use digital maps, most smartphones have a built-in GPS receiver. A common misconception about the GPS signal is that it necessarily reveals your location to other parties. Actually, the GPS satellites send out a one-way radio signal, and each GPS-enabled device passively calculates its position using these signals. That's why GPS and the many alternatives like Galileo, GLONASS, or Beidou work without an internet connection. Only when the receiving device has an active sender, like a cell phone does, might the location be sent elsewhere, for example by a navigation app. Since GPS waves are sometimes difficult to receive, for example indoors, navigation apps commonly use a hybrid positioning system that combines GPS and network information like Wi-Fi and Bluetooth signals. If the mapping service knows the identifiers and location of Wi-Fi networks, for example through crowdsourced acquisition, or by collecting this data itself, it is possible to calculate the phone's rough position using triangulation. Some retail stores try to track shoppers based on their Bluetooth devices, since Bluetooth and Wi-Fi signals broadcast a unique serial number called the MAC address. But recent Android and iOS versions make this type of tracking much more difficult by randomizing the MAC address. By the way, if you ever wondered where the data for the Google Maps feature Popular Times comes from, it's from users who opted into Location History, a service that makes use of such a hybrid positioning system. If you care about digital privacy, be careful who has access to your phone's geolocation data. Data brokerage is its own industry that has plenty of customers. To protect yourself, at least to some degree, use the approximate location feature as often as possible if you need location services, and only allow permanent location access to the most important apps. Turning off your phone to avoid being tracked is another option, but as whistleblower Edward Snowden pointed out, how would you know if a smartphone with a built-in battery is actually off? Malware with fake shutdown animations already exists. Well, I guess it's back to the dark ages. Thank you to patron Joe Bloggs and all other patrons and subscribers for supporting the SensiClick channel.